Harmon, your education continues. You'll never guess what the contrabassoon is all about.
We get it. It's going to be a low-sounding instrument.
Yeah, I mean, it's pretty obvious now. You did this last time with the E-flat clarinet.
It appears you're starting to get predictable 4/4. What a pity.
You think I'm predictable, eh?
Let's show you just how much I can shake things up.
Oh no, what did you do?
It's kind of cool being a computer.
Help, help, what do I do with these arms?
Oh, enough, enough. Your next lesson is at hand, Harmon. But the teacher of all things contrabassoon is outside of my reach. He's on the other side of the cosmos. In Thunder Bay.
Wow! That's really far!
You'll have to initiate contact yourself. There's only so much I can do.
Hi, Harmon!
Hi, Aviner! Sorry to surprise you like this, but my friend here says you're an expert on the contrabassoon?
Well, you've come to the right place. I happen to have a contrabassoon right here.
Wow! It's kind of like a regular bassoon, but boy, oh boy, it's a lot bigger.
That's right. And like you probably guessed, it's a lot lower than the regular bassoon as well.
I think that shook the whole galaxy. How do you play the contrabassoon?
Just like on the regular bassoon, the sound is created by the reed here. The air from the reed goes through this metal pipe here, then all the way down, all the way back up, down again, all the way up again, and finally out the end here. I use my fingers to move these keys around. The keys open and close holes along the tube that let me change the notes that the contrabassoon plays.
I like those shiny keys. So, does the contrabassoon always end up sounding so loud and brash?
Well, the contrabassoon can actually play very soft, and it can play quite high. But mostly what it's good for is playing low and playing loud. It just kind of has that beastly character.
Able to play low and loud actually sounds like a lot of fun. Maybe I'll play the contrabassoon from my audition on Piano 3. Thanks, Aviner.
Bye, Harmon.
Well, Harmon, what do you think about the contrabassoon?
I love it. It's so big and heavy and low. It sounds amazing.
Would you like to hear some music featuring the contrabassoon?
Oh boy, would I ever!
The Kingston Symphony is working on a piece by Maurice Ravel as we speak, and it features the contrabassoon. I want you to listen for the following things. Show off, write this down.
Sigh, at least we're getting closer.
This piece tells the musical story of Beauty and the Beast. You'll hear a lovely clarinet solo. That's the beauty. And you'll hear the contrabassoon. That's the beast. When you hear the clarinet and contrabassoon start to waltz together, raise your paw. Sound good?
It sounds great.
Right then. Kingston Symphony, take it away.
Thank you.
the sound of that contrabassoon! It's like nothing else I've heard in the orchestra!
Now approaching the Zauberflöte system. 5 sectors remaining until we arrive at Ripiano 3.
We'll be at the audition soon! Good thing I've chosen my instrument. I'm going to play the contrabassoon.
Oh, really? Are you sure you don't want to play the glockenspiel?
The what?
Will Harmon learn about all the instruments in the orchestra? And which one will she decide to play for her audition? Tune in next time to find out.